I am Jack Blades.
I'm Jeff Watson
from Night Ranger. And this is Classic Rock. What up, dudes? So we filmed this video. A friend of mine was going to UCLA film school. So on a weekend, we checked out all the gear for the video, Don't Tell Me Love Me. So we did this video for $10,000. I mean, and that was an unheard of sum then. And MTV was this like fledgling little thing. And at that point, it was such a beginning of it, they didn't have a lot of videos. So we gave them our video, and consequently, you know, they played it every 20 minutes.
That's right.
It was like us and Duran Duran, you know, Hungry Like a Wolf and Don't Tell Me You Love Me. And they played this thing nonstop. Don't tell me you love me. Don't tell me you love me. Don't tell me I know what I know. We're a hitherto unknown band, and after all of a sudden, Don't Tell Me You Love Me, everybody's like going, hey, Don't Tell Me You Love Me. And you know, kids are, everybody's walking up to us, and we're just going, wow, this is wild. How do these people know who we are in you know, Duluth, Minnesota, you know? And it was just crazy, and suddenly it was like, wow.
Duluth?
Minnesota. Isn't it Minnesota?
Night Ranger! And Night Ranger rocks!
I like Night Ranger personally because they're great songwriters. I've been watching Jack Blades for years, and they're just totally awesome.
My brother died of a drug overdose many, many years ago, and it was funny because I never had, I never had a chance to say goodbye. And so I think that song, for me, and when I heard the music, you know, one morning I just woke up, and I was sitting in my bedroom, and I just woke up in the morning, and just flew, and 20 minutes later I went, man, that says what I felt. The grief that I went through, and the song, which was a healing for me, in a lot of ways, for other people, they're going through grief, and it's a healing for them also.
As the sun hides its head, we're under the night's rest, and the wind sings its same old song. And you on the edge, never close, never far, always there when I need a friend. But it's hard living life on this memory go round, always up, always down, spinning round and round and round. And all this could be such a dream, so it seemed I was never much good at goodbye. There once was a time, never far from my mind, on the beach on the 4th of July. I remember the sand, how you held out your hand, and we took for what seemed a lifetime. But it's hard leaving all this behind me now, like a schoolboy so lost, never found until now. And all this could be such a dream, so it seemed like never much good at goodbye.
So long. And it's hard go round, always up, always down, spinning round and round and round.
And all this could be such a dream, so it seemed I was never much good at goodbye. And all this could be such a dream, so it seemed I was never much good at goodbye, goodbye,
so long.
Oh yeah!
Hi, I'm Jack Blades.
I'm Jeff Watson from
Night Ranger.
And Classic Rock will continue from the Wild Horse when we return.
Woohoo! Vinyl to CD, I think, was in a lot of ways, it kind of ended that great era of amazing artwork from the, you know, 60s, 70s, and 80s. And oh, I liked Midnight Madness.
Midnight Madness.
I like Midnight Madness because we just got a bunch of our insane, crazy, freaked out friends and all of us and went onto the
Universal lot
into New York Street, what they called, and we just went to the wardrobe department and said, anybody pick whatever you want, wear some wild thing. And it was just a blast, and we just filmed it like 2 or 3 in the morning, just drinking beers and just having a wild time and everybody going crazy. It was so much fun. So much so that when we got the cover, it was too chaotic, and they're all worried that it's like too crazy and everything like that.
So they put our big pictures,
the big, you know, five of us, all like, you know, big mugs stuck on the right thing, and we're like, oh no, you really. But on the backside, you see people all over the thing. It was pretty funny. That was really one of my favorites.
Let's do something off the Midnight Madness CD. Y'all might remember this one.
Yeah.
It's falling apart, and you knew it was gone from the very start. Do you close your eyes and dream about me? Come on. A girl in love with a gleam in your eye. I was a younger boy, all dressed in white. We're older now, I bet you still think about me. Yeah! I remember we learned about love.
You all know what I'm talking about, eh?
Could have done in a different kind of way. But that ain't you. You play tough when you play. Close your eyes.
I'm Jack Blades.
I'm Jeff Watson
from Night Ranger. And we'll be right back with some more great hits on Classic Rock.
So don't go away.
Crush on Jack Blades, bass player for Night Ranger. Had it for about 20 years. Still have it. Probably always will. And so I just came here tonight to see Jack.
Night Ranger songs are definitely a classic to me because I grew up listening to them. I saw them in concert in seventh grade and I have all their tapes and I wore them out.
My favorite Night Ranger song is Sister Christian, primarily because it's a very good song and I learned more about it every single time I heard it on the radio. It was just a very intriguing song. It's a very smart song.
Sister Christian, the song written by Kelly Kagi.
Our drummer.
And sang it. And he wrote it about his sister. And didn't it used to be called Sister Christy?
His sister's is, her name is Christy. Yeah. And so Kelly was singing the song. It's like, Sister Christy all the time. And we all thought he was saying Sister Christian. We're going, man, that's cool. Yeah, that's really great. That's attitude, you know. And then one day he wrote down the lyrics, and we're looking at these lyrics, and he goes, Sister Christy. And we're like,
who's Christy? What,
who's Christy? What's this? Well, my sister Christian. We're like, oh, man, it's Sister Christian. He goes, well, that's not my sister's name. We changed it to Sister Christian. And, you know, and then it just took off and became this... our huge big hit in our second album. We're in Rochester, Minnesota, and we're the ladies were going through the food line. The Coliseum was like sold out, and you know Sister Christian was flying on the charts. And the lady behind the thing is feeding us. She says, "Is that about a nun who sells dope to school kids?" And Kelly and I look at each other and we go, "Yes, ma'am. It certainly is. That's exactly what it is about." And down we we're like looking at her. Where do these people get these ideas?
It's about Kelly's sister looking to meet people, looking to meet men, and just getting on with her life and coming to grips with her teenage years.
And motoring, which is the chorus, motoring. And it is really, she lived in a small town in Oregon, so every Friday and Saturday night, everyone would get in the cars and drive up and down this one strip.
Cruise, you know,
and they cruise. Yeah, they cruise, and what they called it was motoring.
Sister Christian, oh, the time has come, and you know that you're the only one to say, okay, where you go and what you looking for, you know those boys don't wanna with you.
Not gonna play now. It's true. Now you wanna sing along with us? Come on. Are you ready?
Mama's worrying that you won't last to sing. Let's play. Sister Christian, there's so much in life. Don't you give it up before your time is due. I think it's true, and I know it's
said, Christian, oh, the time has come. And you know, you're the only one to say. Okay. Put your motor in.